Okay, so we have seen that there is a problem when multiple instructions execute in the same cycle, and the problem occurs because we need to read registers before the previous instructions have written them, because those previous instructions now execute at the same time as our instruction. And we have seen that the problem really occurs in the execute stage because we are just operating on wrong values. So let's see in the execute stage if forwarding can help us with this. If you remember your pipelining, what forwarding does is it feeds the value from the previous instruction to the subsequent instructions before those values have actually been written to registers. So let's see if that helps. If you remember, we had our instructions, and now we are just going to look at the execute stage. And we're going to have our instruction just be I1, I2, I3, I4, and I5. And remember that there was a dependence from I1 to I2. So now what would happen is we execute I1 at some point, and in the same cycle, we execute I2. So the problem with forwarding is that it would be able to feed this value to the instruction in the next cycle, but not to an instruction in the same cycle. Because basically, if you look at the timeline for the cycle, this is the kind of beginning of the execute stage. This is the end of the execute stage. In here somewhere, we are kind of taking two values, operating on them, producing a result. This result is available kind of here at the end of the cycle. Meanwhile, the other instruction is taking its values, doing a subtraction, producing a result, and this is where forwarding can provide this value. If forwarding worked, it would have to provide the value here, and any arrow that goes backward here means basically time travel. So pretty much you would produce a result in, you know, one cycle, send it back in time 1 nanosecond earlier so that it can be used here, which is of course impossible. So we cannot do that. What we will do is not execute this instruction here. We will have to stall, meaning this instruction has to be delayed. It just cannot execute in this cycle. It will execute in the next cycle. If I3, I4, and I5 don't have any dependencies with I1, they can still execute in, you know, they have read the right register values, they're going to be able to execute. So now what we have is really, we spent two cycles executing five instructions. Okay, so if we ignore the filling of the pipeline and so on, basically what we have now is the CPI is equal to 2 over 5 in this case, which is approximately 0.4. Actually, it is 0.4. So what we have is a CPI of, you know, instead of it being 0.2 for these five instructions, it would be 0.4. If we have a lot of instructions, there will be a lot of these dependencies, so we will actually have to spend, you know, we will have a CPI that is not zero, even if we had an infinite number of execution units.